I've always been involved in outdoor recreation, wildlife, being brought up in Hingham. When I was a youngster, there was a lot of woods. We did a lot of fishing, a lot of hunting, a lot of trapping and so forth. And I always loved the outdoors and wildlife. I'd pick up a frog all the time, you know, try to study it and so forth and so on. 25 years ago, I took a lesson on how to whittle from a fella down in Kingston. And from that day on, I was hooked on carving. So I took it another step. I studied the wildlife along the Weir River, the estuary, the birds, the mammals, the snakes, the turtles, everything that frequents this area. So I started to take photographs. I had a nice telephoto lens. I started to take pictures of these animals and mammals and birds and so forth. I'd blow them up, study them and so forth. Rather than just carve ducks, which I was doing, I said, I'm gonna branch out and do some mammals and do some birds. So I started a series of birds that visit the estuary, the Weir River. I do mammals that I've seen in the area and reptiles. So I've covered the whole thing. I also teach, and I'm trying to broaden everybody's mind into the estuary. We come down here, we'll carve down here sometimes, and they get into it. And I've had people coming back for the last 10, 12 years that have taken lessons from me every year. They just keep on coming back, and they're into it. Some people are just unbelievable. Once they start, it was just like myself, get hooked on this hobby. And I also teach down in Nantucket. As you can see behind me, the different seasons down here, you'll get the shorebirds, which are starting to come in now, and they migrate through here, and they'll feed along the river before they head south. I'll see flocks of sandpipers and yellowlakes come through here, you know, 10, 20 to a flock during the fall. So it's quite interesting. And I fish out here, so I'll catch striped bass out here, and I carve striped bass. So anything I can see, photograph, or catch, I'll carve one. Most of my carvings I do out of white cedar, white pine, and occasional basswood. And I try to get local wood. People know I carve, so if they're taking down a white cedar or white pine or something that I might be interested in, they'll call me, ask me if I'm interested, and I said, sure. They'll cut it up into log lengths, and then I'll dry it, usually up on top of the barn where it's nice and warm. I think my artwork, exposing the other people to it, it brings them around too, to the wildlife. And they'll come down here, and they said, yeah, I didn't know this existed, you know. We'll come down here, sometimes we'll do a little fly fishing once in a while, catch a couple of small fish, you know. And it excites them, I'm telling you. And then we'll see a bird or something and say, gee, we'll carve one of these next class. Good idea. So they get into it, and I think that has a lot to do with the estuary and the carving. I think they make a good pair. Well, the estuary, I was involved in the estuary for many years with Faith Burbank before Patty got into it. We did a lot of work. Me and her secured two pieces of land in the estuary through hard work between the town and the people that own the land. It was worked on it for years, but we acquired 3.5 acres right out front here, which butts up against the estuary. So we're saving that. I'm the steward of that piece of property. I take care of the lawn. I pick up the rubbish. My wife picks up the rubbish. It's my pet peeve. People throwing stuff out the windows into the grass. We also secured a piece of land over here with a few acres on a pond. And that's attached to the estuary with a little stream that flows out. It's turned out to be a positive thing for me. I mean, knowing we got two pieces of land saved for the future, I think we owe it to the people that have lived here in the past also to try to preserve as much as we can, and for the people of the future. I mean, there's so much development going on here. You've got to start to save something for the future, or we'll all be too crowded.